Family.
Family. Y'all getting it?
We are blessed. And because we're blessed, we turn that blessing back out in praise.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Blessed be your name in the land.
You sound good.
Streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place. Though I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name.
Here we go.
Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun shining down on me, when the world all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering. Though there's pain in the offering, blessed be your name.
Every blessing.
Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. And blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Yeah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Because you give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. And you take away, you give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name, and blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, yes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Yes, Lord. Woo.
Amen. Be seated. Well, welcome to Ogemaw Hills Church. It is a joy to be gathered in the name of our Savior together this morning. Our God is an awesome God. That's not my stomach, I promise. You ever been in a meeting, sometimes a serious conversation, and that's making more noise than the voice you're using? Just not good. But I just want to welcome you to Ogemaw Hills Church. We're thankful to be gathered together in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. God is having a good day today in his kingdom, and he's inviting us to join him. Isn't that a great thing? Every morning he makes that invitation to us. As we rise through our faith in him, he's having a good day in his kingdom. He invites us into his presence to enjoy him now and forever. Now, obviously, that doesn't mean that it's always going to be sunny and 80 degrees out. You know, there can be some rough times, some things that we face, some relational strains, but as we embrace him in faith and allow him to come into our lives and us to participate in his kingdom, his will being done here on earth as it is in heaven, then good things, God things can take place. God's purposes can be fulfilled, and today's a part of that. So we're thankful that you're here. Just want to call a couple things to your attention here as we start the service. We have a Connect card in every few seats in front of there. If you grab them out of the seat backs and just fill out a Connect card at some point today and let us know that you are here, that would be great. Use this as an opportunity to connect with us, give us some feedback. Most critically, when you turn it over, there's a place to fill out a prayer request on the back. And if you fill out a prayer request and then drop this in the offering baskets a little later on in the service, we'll compile some prayer lists, get those out to our prayer teams, and we will be supporting you in prayer throughout the week. And we love to strengthen one another that way, to be there for each other that way, and so please take advantage of that. If you happen to miss the offering baskets with it, you can walk them out through the doors here, and just on your right then is our welcome center. And if you put the cards there on the desk, we'll get them and get those where they need to go. If you are a first-time guest with us today, we welcome you in the love of God, the love that God has for you, that we have for you, even if we haven't gotten a chance to really meet you yet. We love you as God loves you, and we're thankful that you're here. And so if you'll take your Connect card and go to the welcome desk, we have a gift we'd just love to give you and just shake your hand and put a name with a face, and just thank you for being here with us today. Just a few things to call to your attention. The baby bottle campaign that we were doing is kind of a fun fundraiser for the Area Caring Pregnancy Center and Options Resource Clinic Ministry. We're starting to collect those today, so if you remembered your baby bottle today, we are thankful to collect those. And we've got a basket out on our welcome desk that you can put those in. If you forgot to bring that back and you have one, toss your last bit of change in it and bring it back with you next Sunday so we can get those back to the Caring Pregnancy Center in a timely fashion. Also, this coming Saturday, men, is our Higher Call Men's Conference up at Gaylord E. Free Church. So if you're wanting to go to that, if you've signed up, we've got a ticket for you, unless you've allotted otherwise, and it's still not too late to sign up. We can still get you a ticket if you sign up today and have you go up with the group. We're going to share some carpooling up and things. We've got the small van, but the large van is heading to our next quiz meet. The quizzers are heading out for the quiz ministry, and so we're going to be arranging some rides and things. And so if you specifically would like to have a ride in a church vehicle, please call the church office this week and just let us know. And there's some room, and we'll make a ride for everybody between somebody. We'll make a room for everybody. And so just let us know if you'd like to ride along with somebody, and we'll make arrangements for that. And we are going to meet here at the church Saturday morning at 7:15 to head on up in the conference. Registration and the conference begins at 9. It's going to be a great time together. Also, just pay attention to your bulletin. Lots of upcoming events, lots of things to jump into, lots of small groups, discipleship opportunities to grow in your relationship with God and your relationships with others in there each and every week. And just one more thing I want to call to your attention. We have 2 weeks from today until our annual Bible quizzing fundraiser dessert auction. That's their big fundraiser for the year to support our student ministry Bible quizzing team going to nationals. And this year, Nashville's is in Greenville, Illinois at the Greenville College. It's at Greenville University now, Greenville University. And we need your help with the auction. Those of you that have a sweet tooth and deep pockets, come on out. That's a dangerous combination, a sweet tooth and deep pockets. But we love to do this dessert auction each year to support our quizzers. Just an amazing, amazing ministry as our young people memorize the Word of God, travel here and there and quiz against other teams from other churches, build lasting relationships and lasting appreciation for God's Word. And so we need some donations. We do a silent auction with this as well to support the ministry. And so if you have some new or gently used items you'd like to donate to the silent auction, you can bring those by the office anytime. If you have any question about that, you can see Terry Durfee. Terry's here, and Mike's about two-thirds of the way back. Could you wave a hand, guys, at us? This is Mike and Terry. You can see them if you have any questions about that. Or if you have a fantabulous dessert you would like to donate, that would be a blessing, too, this year. And you can see them about that as well. If you forget their lovely faces, call the church office anytime this week, and we'll connect you. But just looking forward to a great, great time. And then lastly, this next Saturday night or Sunday morning at 2 a.m., the clocks change. And so don't forget, it is spring forward, or you will be the fellow that walks in and everybody will look at you as you walk in an hour late. And nobody wants that. And so don't forget to set your clocks forward this coming Saturday night in preparation for Sunday morning next week. And yes. Yes.
How many here last Easter were part of the choir? How many had fun with that? All right, we're looking to do that again this Easter. So if you like to make a joyful noise, even if you can't carry a tune in a bucket, but you're joyful with the making of a noise, we want to put that Easter party together. See me after service if that's something you're interested in.
Okay, will you kind of be in this area?
Right here.
Okay, so if you're interested in being part of the joy-filled Jesus praise and God is alive, Christ is not in the tomb choir, see Lonnie right after service up here in this area. We'll make that an acronym. We'll work that out. And so if you read between the lines of what Lonnie was saying, he does not want grumpy people who can't sing. So if you're joyful, doesn't matter. But if you're grumpy, we don't want you. No. But please come out. It was an amazing, amazing part of our celebration for Resurrection Day last year. And so come and see Lonnie if you're willing to be a part of that and just celebrate God for who he is. This time I'm going to invite Mark Schultz to come, share about a new ministry in the church and what God's been doing in his life as well.
Three amazing gifts you will receive from Turning Point Ministries. As Lon was just showing you there and talking about blessings, we got an amazing church. We're going to get 10 things, the greatness of God, Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit. And you're going to say it loudly. I'm going to flip it around real quick. How easy is it to say three amazing things that God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit think about you? I'm listening. You're not boasting in you. Other people aren't boasting in you. God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit boast in you. Ladies, you are his princess. He has set you aside, each and every one of you. Doesn't matter what you look like. Does not matter your age. Doesn't matter what other people think of you. You are his princess. He is mesmerized by your beauty, the way you speak, your very being. All of you. All of you. Men, I want you to think whether you've raised a son or have looked at the father. They can be at any sporting event, building anything, and your chest is out like this. I came home, I think last summer. I got a different home. You can see sometimes when Elizabeth and I aren't there, the window's doing this, which means Michael is home. And for some odd reason, in a home that's about 1,600 square foot, you need a box like this that makes the windows shake. So not only is he there, and I'm sorry, it's not Christian music. It's Led Zeppelin and the things I raised him on. But anyway. So I go in there, and I hear it going. And my other son, who's a chef, is sitting there. And there's these knives laid out, beautiful knives. Michael's got his 3 grand guitar. And I'm looking, and Nicholas is sitting there jamming, and he's taking this knife, and he's doing this. It's a $500 knife, so he can take a big onion, boom, 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 and just falls. And Michael is sitting there just rocking, and man, I'm telling you, I'm sitting there, I feel my heart beating, right? And I do what I always do to people that I love. I give left-handed compliments, right? I walk in, and I look at them, and you get kind of melancholy, and you remember when they're young. And I'm looking at these two boys now. The shoulders are taller than I am. And I look at them, and I feel the pride, and I say, you know what? Because their hair is like down about here. I goes, man, you guys are prettier than your mom. Okay? I mean, I just do that. That's my love for them. And turn the music down. Of course, they're going to look at me and go, Dad. But serious, man, the heart's beating three ways to sideways, okay? Now, if me, admittedly imperfect, can feel that way about them, now, I'm not the parent whose little Johnny never does anything wrong. My boys aren't always right. But if I can feel that way about him, my boys, how does God feel about me? A little different animal now, isn't it? So the first thing, we need an hour and a half of your time, scheduled appointment. First thing you get from Turning Point Ministries is identity. Now, second thing, when you look at your children, okay, when they're physically sick, got the flu, would you not take that pain for a day? When children are mean to your child, would you not take that pain for a day? When your child does things wrong, would you not take it from them? So if you're imperfect and you would take that for your children, what's he going to do? What's Jesus going to do? And what's the Holy Spirit going to do? We give that. So the second thing that you will get is healing. Anger, shame, humiliation, rage, addiction, doesn't matter what it is, worry, doubt. It is an hour and a half of your time, that goes. The third thing you get from this time is a new commission, a new job. Now here's where it gets just a little bit weird. We're limited. He's not. He is the proud parent. He has looked at you as the princess. He has looked at you like your son. He's got a job for you that's more than what you think you can do, more than what you think the people around you can do. That's what it is. There are three members in this group, which will already start me laughing because it is not a peas in the pod thing. The first one is called Lita, guidance guru, mom, and crazy old Aunt Terry. It just depends on the day. You cannot get into this church without meeting Terry Leach unless you come in here in the last minute and get out real quick. Terry has somehow been able to take the heart that's located in here and bring it right out, okay? And I will tell you what, comical lady, because I will sit there. I see a million people go to her and talk to her for advice. I don't know why. She has never once told me what I wanted to hear. Not once. I sit there with Terry. I explain worldly. I'm right, guys. I am right. And she takes a Bible and she turns it. And I look and I go, oh, man. So I took her Bible. Oh, really? I was sitting there one day and I went, you know what? I felt one of her induction Bibles. I could feel the blood, sweat, and tears. And I went, I'm taking it and you're not getting it back. And she said, good. You going to read it? I goes, yes. I showed her, didn't I? That's Terry. All heart, got it that there, boom. I'm more in this neighborhood, and I kind of take emotions and feelings, throw them out there, and go, interesting. I don't base decisions on them. I don't base what I do. Total opposites. Then we got the third member of the crew, and right now she's already going, oh, my God. And this is good. Her name is Candy Older. I think she has 27 children, because when you see her walk, they're all going around her 130 miles an hour. You've heard her speak. She's very nice. She's very sweet. You're all wrong. You are all dead wrong. Terry's little sister, Candy's little sister sits back in the car, goes, pick, 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 mom, and you're in trouble. So, Zach, if you are here, it was never your fault. You're absolved, brother. She is the perfect blend and mix between the two, wise beyond her years, heart of gold. Now, the funny part with these three, we don't matter. We mean absolutely nothing. We have learned to facilitate an environment where you get to talk directly to God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit in a way you haven't done before. Now, there will be a day where I will share a little bit more of the personal testimony, but I'm going to be honest here. Authenticity is probably one of the biggest things I measure human beings from. I will never forget the one day where Pastor was talking that sermon on how we might behave differently outside than here. And I ran right up to him and I went, that's why I misbehave here. This way we keep it equal. Okay? When Terry came to me and said, I really need you to keep an open mind and go watch this video, see what it is. I looked at it and I went, wow, this would be great for you. This would be great for everybody. She says, no, I want you to do it. I went, oh, no. No. She goes, I don't want you to do it. I want you to be a part of it. Some people that are a little bit more humble will go, no, no, no. I looked at her. I said, have you completely lost your mind, woman? Completely lost your mind. So, I don't know how to explain this, but, you know, I've always been highly competitive environments, the whole shot right there. I like irritating men. I'm afraid of her and Candy. Third one I'm afraid ever of disappointed sits right near the pastor. I can disappoint him left and right. Doesn't bother me. I still remember Lisa coming up. Would you consider for this Heaven's Gate, Heaven's Flame playing the devil? Got it, kiddo. Got it. So I go, okay? And I am scared to death. I'm thinking of all sorts of different things to do. I hope there's an accident. Nobody gets hurt. I got to fix and go, and I can't make it. And then that little voice comes, they'll just reschedule. So I knew I was screwed. I will tell you, in many of the things, biggest thing that I could not get over was forgiveness. Okay? I cannot contemplate forgiveness when there are human beings out there that go out of their way to hurt, whether physically or whatever else. They're not sorry. Now, part of this process, you will forgive. And it's good that you do. I can't do it. They would do it again. I could not get it. Could not get it. So finally, I'm sitting there, and I'm going through some of these sessions, and I see the release that people get on forgiveness. And I'm thinking, this is great. And then the voice comes, how can you do this when you won't forgive, Mark? So, of course, I have a little different relationship with God. Everybody's different. Some they're going to talk to softly. If you ever watch NCIS, God does this to me. Smacks me upside the head. It's lovingly. But I have maybe a touch of stubbornness. We're going to work on getting to steadfastness from there. But I couldn't forgive. So, finally, after sitting there, you're going to go to the very two that you started. And I'm just going, I don't want to go to Candy and Terry. Don't want to do it. I want to go to another guy who agrees with me and goes, take care of it, Mark. That would feel much better. Can't do it. So I dread that day coming. Well, I'm part of that jail ministry, and I sat there, and here's where I'm going to finish. Praise team, I'm going to have you come up so we don't lose time here. I plan on going to see Terry and Candy right around 2:30. Walk in that very first jail ministry. I see a guy that comes in, young gentleman, intel straight from the streets of Flint. You can feel the hair go back on your head. This is the guy. This guy that runs a drug thing. He sits down. I said, tell me a little bit about yourself. Well, when I was 11 years old, I killed a man. I said, okay, it's interesting. Well, he's trying to hurt my mom. And so I killed him. So I've been in and out of the prison system forever. At 14, down in Flint, there was a man killing prostitutes. My mom was a prostitute. My mom was murdered. Okay. He said, you know, I'm sitting in a prison cell X amount of years ago, heard God say to forgive. And Mark, I sat down on my knees. I can't explain it. My mom was the only thing that's ever meant anything to me. And he said, I felt the release. I felt that changed. I can't get out of the Bible. I went, okay, I think I got forgiveness now, guys. I think I got it. Walked out of that jail. Sorry, God. Sorry for holding anything like that. Get done. I feel that same release. And I go, best news. I don't have to go talk to Terry and Candy. He said, oh, no, you still got to share. I'm like, ah! So I can't promise you complete comfort. But I can promise you, in that time frame, a level of communication, a level of feeling, and a level of love that is hard to attain by yourself. So get a hold of both of them. You can get a hold of me, but I'm going to send you to one of the other two, okay? Make the schedule. Do it. I promise you a gift that far exceeds anything you will receive on your own. Thank you, church.
Would you stand? Let's continue our worship.
Alone in my sorrow and dead in my sin, lost without hope, no place to begin. Love made a way to let mercy come in when death was the rest and my life began. Ash was redeemed, only beauty remained. My open heart was given a name. My morning grew quiet, my feet rose to dance. death was arrested and my life began. Oh, your grace, so free, washes over me. You have made me new, now life begins with you. Released from my chains, I'm a prisoner.
Yeah!
My shame was a ransom. My debt, he called me his friend. When death was arrested and my life began, oh, your grace, so free, washes over me. You have made me new, now life begins with you. Darkness rejoiced as though heaven had lost.
No.
But then Jesus arose with our freedom in hand. That's when death was arrested and my life began. That's when death was arrested and my life began. Oh, your grace.
As Mark was saying, you know, that proud father stuff, you know, when you see your children doing things. I remember when my children were young and like toddlers where you're putting them to bed and you have those nightly routines with them where, you know, like I couldn't get out of my daughter Jasmine's room without singing a song. There was a particular song that we sang called I Am a Promise. It was an old Bill Gaither children's thing. And that singing over your children. You know, the book of Nehemiah describes God like that to us. It says he will save, he will rejoice over us. He will sing over us. And we get just amazed. Like Mark was saying, we, the way we love our kids, we think we really do a good job, and we do. But, man, that pales in comparison to the way that God loves on us.
You dance over me.
While I am unaware, you see all around, but I never hear the sound.
Sing it again, you dance.
You dance over me while I am unaware.
You sing.
You sing all around, but I never hear the sound. And Lord, I'm amazed by Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed by you and how you love me. You paint the morning sky with me. My hope will always stay, for you hold me in your hand. And Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed by you. And how you love me. Say, I'm amazed. Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed by you. And how you love me.
How deep and how wide.
How deep,
how deep,
how
wide,
how wide, how great,
how great
is your love for me.
Say again, how deep?
How deep. How wide,
how wide,
how great is your love for me.
How deep and wide.
Oh, how deep, how wide. Amazed by you and how you love me.
Sing it, church. I'm amazed.
Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed.
Oh, yes, I am.
Lord, and how you love me.
Let's sing it again.
Lord, I'm amazed by you. Lord, I'm amazed. Lord, I'm amazed. simply amazed how deep and wide is that love of God. That while we were yet still sinners, he sent his son to die for us. He knows all of our faults. He knows all of our weaknesses. He knows all of our downfalls. He knows all of our history. And he still loves us enough to die for us. And he would do it again today. He would do it tomorrow. He loves us that much. Thank you, Lord. It was. Thank you, God. for seeing the wretch I was and loving me still, blinded in my sin. And you loved me. You saw me through. You took me to the cross where those scales were taken off. I am no longer blinded, but I see. I see the love of God. I see the grace of God. I've experienced forgiveness. I've experienced that amazing grace. We thank you this morning, Lord, for that grace. We thank you that we as a body, your body, can come together and say thank you. We can come together and worship. We can sing. We can praise. We can just stand still and experience your grace, experience your presence. Thank you, Lord, for my brothers and sisters. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of music. And thank you, Lord, for the cross. And at this time, we just say amen. Amen. You may be seated, ushers, if you come forward.
Praise God for the gift of this season of preparation as we head into